Hello. We are going to do something you may say strange. Oh, I need to look at some services here. And delayed start. Okay, they will start up later on. So this is Windows 2022 standard evaluation server, not paid for. I have 170 days left on it. It's actually not that expensive if you buy for private use, I figured out. Let's pretend that we are amazing developers, and you want to use this as a development environment for Python, because that's what I'm going to set it up for, or at least just download and install it. And you may say, why do you want to develop on this and not like, you know, Windows 10 Pro, 11 Pro? Well, you don't get a lot of the unnecessary shit with Windows Server as you get with the Windows Desktop. So you don't have, you know, Xbox and all of these crazy things. You know, you don't have the clip chip or chip clip or what the fuck it's called, the video editing software and stuff like that. You get the bare bones with a server install. So it could potentially be a great start. We can just look at the start menu. Just, you know, this is what comes with it. The only thing I install is the guest edition from VirtualBox. But as you guys probably could see, we didn't even have, like, there's no store in here. There's no store, so we have to go on here and download here. Is there a command line way of installing Python? I don't know. I haven't checked it out, but here, 3.11 is already out. Open it up, and let's keep this away here. So, install now, customizing, including IDLE, PIP, and documentation. So this is the one that you should probably take. And here, add Python exe to path. It's a really good idea to include that one also. And of course, use admin privileges to install it. So we click next. I am, however, just for your clarifications, logged in as administrator right now. I should make a separate user account. I think I will do that. Make a video about how to set up a user account in Windows Server. It could be a great development environment. It don't have to be Python. It could be C Sharp, Java, Rust, Go. Why do that? Because you don't get all of the unnecessary things. This can be a dedicated development environment. You're only going to develop here. So down here, it tells you courses and what's new and stuff like here. Disable path limits. Change your machine configuration to allow programs including Python to bypass the 260 character max path limit. I always do this. I don't know if you should do it or if you should not do it. I just always do it. I'm not smart enough to basically have an opinion on that. I just think it's, well, if it's there and they ask us to do it, well, why not do it? This should be it. So if you go up here and we do PowerShell, we go in here and we do Python 3, and I fucked something up. Or if we just type Python, sorry, under Windows 11 normally I have to type Python 3. I think it's because I also have Python 2 installed. So if I can remember how to print something in Hello World here, am I using the wrong keyboard? Yeah, it's set to American. Will this work? Yeah, that would work. So now we have Python in there. We can also Control C, I think it is. Is that not Control Z? There you go. Clear this up. So if we do Python -- version. Oh, for fuck's sake, I have to remember I'm on American. There you go. It tells you what version you have installed. Now you're running it, you can set up. Maybe I should make a video about how to set up a virtual Python environment, because that could be a good idea to do that. You know, so you can test different, you can have different projects that, you know, rely on different libraries. So you have them contained within the base. It's kind of like a virtual machine for Python. So let's say I have a program that needs to import a machine learning library. So I can use that virtual environment. So only that virtual environment will have that machine coding library or machine learning library in there. So when I delete that environment, it's not, you know, messing up my normal Python routines and stuff like that. And like I said, it could be a really, really good idea to use something like Windows Server And you don't have to use the latest one, because let's say you want to not spend so much money on it. Get Windows Server 2015, 16, 17. They are often on sale for not a lot of money. Like, I mean, not a lot of money. Especially if you hunt down keys or out on the webs. And then you have like a bare bone Windows install. Like, absolutely bare bone. That you can focus on coding. So don't install Discord, don't install gaming launches, don't install Twitter or go on to Twitter. Only have your environments that you need and use whatever browser you want, if you don't want to use Edge, to have the documentation on. The less cluttered or the less distractions that you can get, the better it is for you. Could I do this on my Windows 11 install? Yes, but I have all my gaming launches there, I have all my fucking video editing shit, I have Twitter open, I have Discord open. I'm just setting myself up. Yes, I can set them into Do Not Disturb mode and stuff like that, but they are still there. You still see them down here. I just found it really, really fun to do it like that. I may actually even activate this Windows version here and use it as my development machine. Use Windows Server as a development machine. Anyway, I'm going in circle, playing with my fidget spinner here, and see you all later. Have an amazing day. Bye-bye.